Hey, scholars, it's Miss Little. I'm sitting here on my patio, just gonna do some art with you if that's okay. I hope you're doing okay. I've missed seeing you, but at least we still get to do art together, right? Okay, so the things that you're gonna need for this art project is pencil, paper, maybe a Sharpie marker if your parents let you use it. If not, that's okay, don't be worried. You just can't spray water on it, that's okay. And I have some markers, but you don't have to have markers. If you have crayons, you could use crayons. You don't even have to use crayons. You can just have everything black and white if you want. That's perfectly fine, okay? So take a second to get started. Go get your things ready, and we will get started in just a second. Okay, if you're not ready yet, just push pause, and then we'll get back to it, okay? This is my paper. This is what I'm gonna use, okay? And I have to use a Sharpie marker because you won't be able to see me drawing with the pencil. Let me show you. See, it's just, if I do this, you can't see. And that's if I'm pressing really hard. Okay, so I have to use a Sharpie so that you can see it. But you wanna use a pencil so that you can erase. And then let's review really quick how to make our marks with our pencil without making a dent in the paper. Because once you make a dent, it gets really, really hard to erase, right? So take your pencil, gently on your hand. This is how you draw soft lines with your pencil, okay? If you're pressing so hard on your paper that it would hurt your hand, it's hurting the paper too, okay? And if you make a dent in the paper, press too hard, when you try to erase your lines, it's just gonna be kind of messy. So it just takes practice. If you make a mistake, that's okay, okay? I hope you're ready. I hope you've had time to get all your stuff. We are going to draw a, should I tell you? Yeah, I should tell you. We're gonna draw a rabbit. Okay, here's what he's gonna look like when you're done. Okay, and we are going to make a background that's gonna look sort of like this. Okay, now, to draw your rabbit, the very first thing you need to do is draw the shape of a pear. Have you ever seen a pear? Like a piece of fruit. And I'm gonna draw one here, about in the middle, but a little bit higher than the middle. It's gonna look like this. Does that look like a rabbit to you? How do we know what a rabbit really looks like? How are we gonna draw something that we've never seen before? Or if we have seen it, it's just like a cartoon picture. Like, how are we gonna know? I think I have a solution. Hold on one second. Okay, I'm back. Are you ready? Okay, hopefully this is loud enough because I've tried to record before and it wasn't quite loud enough, but hopefully. Who is this? What? This is Elvis, the rabbit. He's a baby. He is 3 months old. Look at his feet. Are they the cutest thing you've ever seen? Oh, careful, 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 buddy. So this is Elvis the bunny. Oh, he's so scared. He's just a baby. I'm holding real tight. And he is going to show us what a rabbit actually looks like. Okay? So I'm going to turn him around. Just take just a second. Calm down. Okay. Now, do you see the shape of his head? First of all, he's got floppy ears, doesn't he? Aren't those adorable? But his head is pear-shaped. Can you see if he's looking straight at us? Also, I want you to notice his eyes. Are his eyes facing forward like my eyes? Or are they mostly on the side of his head? See, when I do the side of his head, now his eyes facing forward. Looky here. I can barely see his eyes. Yikes. Okay, so how are we going to draw that? And then here's his fluffy, fluffy feet and his little fluffy tail. Isn't he so cute? Look at all those whiskers. Can you see all the whiskers? Okay, we have a real challenge to be able to draw this little fella, right? Okay, let me put him up and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So now we can draw this pear shape with a little more conviction, huh? Okay, so first you're gonna draw the pear. And I'm gonna go fast, and if I get too fast, then you can just push pause on the video and slow it down, okay? The next thing we're gonna draw is a circle down at the bottom of our pear, like this, okay? And then we are going to draw his nose, and his nose is going to look like a little V. A little V shape with his little bitty mouth. Aww. You can draw little teeth down there if you want to. Or you can draw a tongue. But I would wait to put the details on until later. Okay. The next thing we're going to draw, I'm going to come up here and make a little dot so that I know where I'm drawing to. So I made a dot here, here, and then a dot here, and a dot here. And I'm going to connect my lines, but with this, with the curve. Okay? So here like this, and here like this. There we go. Okay. All right. Now we're going to draw his eyes. And his eyes are going to be, well, let me just show you. They're going to be a little bit of an oval shape. Because they're a little bit on the side of his head, remember? And his eyelashes are going to be over here. Even the boy rabbits have eyelashes. Elvis has really pretty eyelashes. And you can even leave a little white spot in his eye for a sparkle. I'm going to color it in so you can see it. Okay. If I go too fast, don't forget to pause. All right. There we go. What's he missing? I feel like we are missing something. Maybe some ears. Do you want to make your rabbit's ears long and tall? Or do you want to make them floppy like Elvis's ears? You get to choose. I'm going to do one ear of each so that you can see how to do it. Okay? So I'm going to start here at the top of his head. Not at the very top, but, you know, on the side. Go up here for one ear. He's long. I like long ears. Okay. And down here for sure, for a floppy. Okay? If you like a rabbit with little tiny ears, you could do a short ear if you want to. It's up to you. Some rabbits have short ears. Okay. And he has no body. So we're going to just draw his body right here. Okay. If you don't want to cut your rabbit out, you can draw little feet here. That. And you could even make a background on this piece of paper if you want to. Okay? Sometimes they have different colors, and I like to do like this. So you can see he has a different color. You can color it different. Okay? Rabbits also have little whiskers, so you could put stuff here if you want to. You can make him eyebrows. You can make a little wrinkle on his nose. Or rosy cheeks if you want to. You make this rabbit however you want. It's yours. If you want to put a flower in its hair up here, you can. Put a hat on it. It's up to you. However you want to do your rabbit. But make sure you're going to do the background and the foreground. Coloring in all of it and making sure you get all the details on there. Because the details are what tell the story. Now, if you want to do the background that we did, me and my kids, I'm going to show it to you. Oh, wait. I skipped a spot. This rabbit has all these hairs on it. Okay, so if you want to do those little hairs, let me show you how to do that. And then we'll do the background. Okay, so here's a picture of the rabbit. And what I did, you can see, I think, I took my pencil and I made little lines. And up here I did the same thing. And then I filled in the lines with my marker. So I'll show you how that works. It's going to go like this. See, it goes pretty fast. It's actually faster than coloring the whole rabbit. Okay? And you do that until you get him all colored in with the little lines. Okay? So you can do it that way. Then, for your background, what I did was made a little circle. It's pretty simple. And then I took my marker And I scribble scrabbled a little bit. I scribble scrabbled all the way around. And it looks kind of cool, even if you leave it like this. So I can scribble one color, and then I could add, say, another color outside, like this. And that still looks pretty cool. So if you did not use a Sharpie, or if you don't have a little water squirt bottle, then you can just leave yours just like that. And your rabbit's gonna look really cool in that. But if you happen to have a little spray bottle of water, make sure with your parent that it is water, then you can give it a little squirt, and then you can see what happens. The lines get all blurry, and it kind of looks like it's not in focus. Like if you took a picture, it's in the background, so it's not in focus. And then if you cut your rabbit out with all the dark lines that you put on there, there's a lot of contrast. Okay, now what would look even better than what Miss Little did is if I had more and more and more flowers back here. So do you see all this white space? Oh, wouldn't that look cool if this bunny was really the only white thing on this paper and just fill the whole thing in? That would be impressive. I bet when people saw it, they would go, wow, you worked really hard on that. Okay, so there is our project for today. I hope you had a really fun time. I sure have missed seeing you, and I hope that I get to see the art that you've made. So if you've made some art, even if it's not what we just did, maybe you made some art on your own. Maybe you thought of your own project. I want to see it. Take a picture. And I will post it to our new art club website and the art gallery, and everybody will be able to see it. Won't that be the coolest? Okay. So until next time, I will see y'all later.